で、彼女に始めるという形で書いてるんですが、まずは彼女の杖馬寮さんのよこがおが、まあ、その以前に見た写真がとても美しいよこがおの写真を見ていて、それでまずよこがおというタイトルにしました。
So thank you very much for watching everybody. The reason that I titled my film a profile, side profile, as Giovanna just mentioned, there are a couple of reasons. First of all, I'd like to say that I started writing the script. When I started writing the script, I made the offer to Mariko Tsutsui to take this role for me. So it was based on her taking that role that I wrote the script. And a while back, when I looked at her profile, I found it really, really beautiful. So that's one of the reasons.
また内容的には、いわばその横顔っていうの、人の横顔というのは、片目は見ていても、もう片目は見えないっていう、その人間のその多面性みたいなもの、その、誰もが、誰と話しているか、それで人との関係性によって、その見える姿や、そのキャラクターが変わっていくという、そういったその、まあ、人間の多面性みたいなものを表現し、象徴しています。
So the other reason why I call it profile is that when you think about a person's profile, you only see one side of that person, and that person, any person, has various aspects to themselves. And so when you're talking to somebody, you're only seeing one side of that person, but that person might be multifaceted.
And also,
Yoko
Gao is
about
capability and responsibility. Is the chica guilty because she introduced the nephew to Motoko and Saki, or is this just an unfortunate coincidence?
はい、私はその彼女の家の親戚を紹介して、たまたまその甥が犯罪を犯してしまったというのは、彼女自身は、別に罪はないと思っています。アシケ。
Well, I'd like to say, first of all, that as far as Ichiko is concerned, she has absolutely no responsibility. She has introduced unwittingly that nephew to the girls.
でそれこそが不条理だと思うんですけど、なんだろう、よく日本だと因果応報という言葉がありますけど、その悪いことをした人は忘れられて、いいことをしていたら報われるという、そういった考え方は私はとても人工的で不自然だと考えています。悪いことをした人が自然災害に遭うのではないですし、いいことをした人が必ずしも救われるとは限りません。その自然の設計というのはもうちょっとその無比で、その人間のそういった感情とは別にあるものだと思っています。
So really it's part of an absolutely absurd injustice that's befalling her. And in Japanese we have this word inga oho. I could say, I guess I could translate it as karma. And that nice things happen to nice people and bad things happen to bad people. But I find this a very very artificial statementthings don't happen that way at all, and it doesn't mean that somebody who was bad will be meeting some very natural catastrophe, and that some good people will always be saved. And that doesn't happen at all, and things are much more cruel in reality.
彼女は彼女に罪はなかったと思いますけど、ただ彼女は弱い人間だったと思います。その自分の甥が犯罪を犯してしまったということを、その女の子の家族に彼女が言うことができなかった、その元子という女の子に言わないでと言われて、それに従ってしまった、もしかしたらこのまま言わなければ自分はそのままこの隠せるかもしれないと考えてしまった弱さが彼女になったと思います。ただ弱いことは罪ではないと思います。
Yes, she's not to blame, but I will say that she was weakyou see, her nephew committed a crime. She was not able to tell the family that she was related to that boy, and she let herself be persuaded, convinced by Motoko not to say anything to the family. So that was her weakness. She's not to blame, but that was her weakness, I suppose.
はい、ありがとうございます。まず、監督にとっていい演技を映画に残すためにまずすべきことは、いい配慮を選ぶということです。
First of all, as a director, if you want to have good acting, you have to choose a good actor. That's the first thing to do.
で、その上で、まず、私のすべきと仕事としては、俳優ができるだけ自由に演じられるように、その良い脚本、良い構成の脚本を書くということです。
And the second thing as a director for me to do is to give as much freedom for the actors to do a good job. I have to write a good script. I have to provide them with a good script.
その上で、リハーサルを経て本番に入りました。で、リハーサルだけではなく、特にその、辻丸子さんも、辻丸子さんは、例えばその訪問看護師という役のために、その取材を重ねて、また途中、ビリになる場面があったと思うんですけど、あそこ実は、思想高校、四つ足で歩く専門家の方に、指導してもらいました。
And based on that, I will tell you a little bit about what happened to Mariko Tsutsui, her process. We went through a rehearsal, obviously, and what she did was she really did a lot of research for her roles. For example, when she was she had the role of playing the nurse who goes to people's homes and provides care there.She did really research the role. She went to those kinds of nursing stations to see what was going on. And you saw also a scene where she was acting like a dog on her, she was on all fours. And she actually got some direction and some instruction from somebody who was actually a motion coach and specialized in acting like a dog on all fours. And so she took lessons from that person.
Other questions?
映画はその人を見るとどう考えているかというのは私が正解を言っているわけではなくて、まず基本的には見た人がその自由に考えてほしいと思っています。
First of all, I'll just say, begin by saying that in the film, in my film, the characters, I do not really have a correct one answer of what they're feeling, and so that's really up to the spectator.
その上で私の解釈を話すと、彼女はそのいわば男というその一子にとっては非常に一子が転落していくきっかけとなった女性が一子と同じような仕事に就いているということに対して多分大きなショックを受けたはずです。で、彼女はその果たせなかった復讐というものを、男に対して男を車で引いてしまうところで果たそうとしたのかもしれません。
Based on having said that, if I give you my interpretation of things, Ichiko, first of all, realizing that Motoko, the person who was the reason for her fall, has taken on the same profession, so probably she was really shocked at that. And she did, I'm sure she did think of a revenge, and maybe she could sort of run over Motoko. She might have, that thought might have crossed her mind.
しかし、道徳的には正しくなくとも、あそこでアクセルを踏み込めてしまうというのは、私はその、ある意味で強い人間だと思います。しかし、私たちの大半は、おそらくあそこでアクセルを踏むことができず、元子を殺すということで、復讐を果たす、恨みを果たすことはできない人間が私たちも皆さんもほとんどだと思います。
So, let's not think about moral for one second, but if somebody was able to, at that point,put their foot on the accelerator and run over Motoko. Of course, that kind of person would have been a very strong-willed, strong person. But most Ichiko wasn't strong like that, and so she wasn't able to take revenge. But most of us are like Ichiko, and we wouldn't be able to put our foot to the pedal.
Ichiko's life was, Motoko, まあ、特に闇を話すことも許すこともできないままそのままだらだらと続いていってしまう。その彼女の人生はおそらく続いていってしまうだろうというそういったやっぱ日本語で言うとこれまた翻訳が難しいかもしれませんが、職業無常のようなそういった感覚を笑っているといいますね、はい、描いているものだと描きたいと思いました。
So, I'm assuming that Ichiko's life will go on that way. She cannot take revenge, nor can she forgive Motoko. And so her life will just keep on going, and going through the motion. And so we have another expression. I'm sure it's very difficult for my interpreter to translate this. The shogyo mujo, nothing stays the same, like water running. But I'm imagining that this is what will happen to Ichiko.
Thank you.
Another question? Yes?
I just want to know how many days you shot that, and also what's the process of when you were writing the script? Did you go away? And
how many days the shooting lasted?
Yeah.
And the script writing process?
Yeah.
Yeah. Thank you.
はい、まず撮影は大体3週間強ですね、で行われました。
So first of all, the shooting took about a little bit more than 3 weeks.
はい、で、台本の方は、もともとはこの、企画をプロデューサーから、このいった企画でやりたいと言われたのは、その女性3人の運命や絡みやブルドー劇のようなものをやりたいという話を受けて、私は脚本を書き始めたんですけど、結局脚本を書いていく過程で、全くどんどんどんどん姿を変えて最初の当初の企画とはだいぶ違ったものになりました。その脚本を直すのには2年間ぐらいかかりました。
So when I first got this project from my producer, he wanted me to write something about three female characters, sort of a group film, but it went through all kinds of permutations, and it went on, and I rewrote and rewrote, and so all in all, it took me this project to be finished. It took me about 2 years.
最後いちこが老いの達夫と男の家を訪ねたらもう売り絵になっていて誰もいないという展開になったと思うんですけど、脚本の最後の方まで撮る予定だったのはあそこにまだ男がいて一緒に先に会いに行くという。そういった話をずっと考えていましたが、それは採用しなかったんですけど、自分の中ではちょっともったいなかったので、その展開もそれはそれで気に入っていたので、小説、これ映画完成したの小説にしたんですけど、小説の方はそういったラストに書いています。
So you also saw a scene towards the end of the film where Ichiko takes her nephew Tatsuo to the house where Motoko used to live.And it was for sale, and there was nobody there. But in my earlier sort of version, I wanted it to end a different way, and I wanted it to be that Motoko was still living in that house, and the three of them go to see Saki. And so that was the end, one of the ending that I had in mind. But I scratched that, but I really couldn't bring myself to completely cancel that idea. It was too bad that I had to.So I hung on to it, and actually there's a novel version of this film which I wrote, and so in the novel version, the novelized version, then the ending is the one that I just said.
Time for one last question.
Yes,
please.
Sorry.
Sorry.
はい、その元と一子の関係はおそらく言葉にしたらその同性愛に近い、同性愛と言っていい関係だと思っています。
Well, if you will actually to put it into words explicitly, I think that there is some kind of homosexual sort of attraction between 元と一子。
はい、私が、その今回その同性愛 LGBT について描くときに取ろうとしたスタンスは、日本の少子化の描こうとするときに多分皆さんはご存じないと思うんですけど、日本の少子化の富岡太鼓さんという、まあ、日本でそのフェミニズムの、非常にフェミニズムにすごく有名な小説家の言葉を思い出しました。
So, some of you may or may not know about this Japanese novelist Taeko Tomioka. She's a very famous Japanese novelist. She's of the feminist persuasion, and I wanted to take her stance on the LGBTQ issue.
She いわばその女性は若いうちに結婚するのが当たり前である、その女性も男性もその若いうちに結婚するのが当たり前であると言われていた時代に、彼女はなんでその、その結婚していないと、その女性が結婚しないとなんで結婚しないのかとすぐ周りから質問されるけど、そもそもその結婚制度っていうものに対して疑いを持つのであれば、そもそも結婚したい人になんで結婚するのかと聞こうがいいんじゃないか、結婚してないのに結婚してない人がなんで結婚してないのと聞かれるのおかしいということを彼女は提言しました。
So one of her statements already 50 years ago in an era where in Japan, in a way, young women and young men for that matter, were told they should marry while they were young. And if you were not married, then you would be asked, why don't you marry? But at that time already she was saying, if you think about marriage as an institution,you should ask people who are getting married why they are getting married and not the other way around.
で、やはり今この今の時代に表現においてそのいわば異性愛の登場人物を描いても何も言われませんが、そういう同性愛の登場人物が出てくると、なんでこの人たちはこのキャラクターを同性愛にしたのかと質問されることがあります。
So in this day and age, if you depict in a heterosexual relationship, people do not ask questions. But then, if you depict people who are in a homosexual relationship, people ask, why did you?
しかし、そもそも私たちの周りには異性愛とも同性愛とも当たり前のようにいるので、そういった質問自体がいつかなくなるといいと思う、なくなるべきなんじゃないかと思うし、そういった気持ちで当たり前のようにその異性愛とも同性愛とも物語の中に登場させたいと考えて脚本を書いています。
So my stance while writing this script is around us it's completely natural to have both homosexual and heterosexual people and relationships. So I would like one day will come that we don't get questions about why did you put a homosexual relationship in the film.
Thank you.